This is Alan Freed, and this is Rock and Roll.
Something soft, just the, look in the middle, sticking one of those things, something but start off with something easy. Ah. I don't know what to say to you anymore.
Ellen, why don't you let up on him?
If I let up on him, we'll be in here listening to Pat Boone all night.
Listen, the show coming up Saturday. Why is everybody so angry about it?
I don't know.
I don't either.
Here's a guy that killed him at the Copa. Walter Winchell wrote about him for 21 straight days, gang. And this one is killing me. If this isn't a record, I never heard one. This is Bobby Darin, and you know where he is. He's in the bathtub.
Splish, splash, I was taking a bath.
It's right about the program. You gotta take it easy. You got that guy climbing the walls.
You never took it easy on me.
Yeah, but you're way ahead of the game. He doesn't know what he's doing.
I always want you because my heart is true. Come, come, come closer. I'll tell you of the ABC.
Hey, baby, nice tips.
Everything I say is true now. Every day my love grows strong.
Jesus.
Here he comes. Hey, what
man,
happened to you?
Man, I'm sorry, man. I couldn't get out the house.
That's cool. That's cool.
Okay, let's go. Where's Al, man?
Where do you think he is? He's up there waiting on us.
Well, come on, let's go.
What's wrong with you, man? You nervous?
No, I just want to do it right, man.
Oh, man, you got to be nervous about nothing, man. Mr. Johnson said we sound just as good as those records.
We're not singing for Mr. Johnson. We're singing for Mr. Alan Freed.
Know that.
Come on. Shoot. We had to rehearse tonight. Hey, man, what's happening?
Hey, listen, I was just getting ready to split. What took you guys so long?
Look at you, Michael. You look like a real juvenile delinquent. I mean, you should take some pride in the way you look. Here you are working in a beautiful office, and what do? You go walking around like a schlump.
All of a sudden, I'm a schlump, huh? Maybe I should start dressing like you.
Well, maybe you should. I mean, look at me. When I go home every night, before I go to bed, I pick out what I'm going to wear, and I coordinate my clothes.
Oh, yeah? Let me see. Oh, this is wool, right? And this is silk? Well, these must be felt.
Get out of here! Oh, don't ever touch me like that again! And just stay away from my desk, too!
I'm just making a joke.
Well, that's not my idea of a joke, and I don't find that funny.
Oh, that's
like
heavy,
right? Like
I'm
Hey, listen, Alan said that the lights can't open or close the show. Christ, what's the problem?
You got a problem with Chuck Berry.
You got to do something special here about Chuck Berry.
All right, listen, he's got an opening act. He doesn't announce. The lights will be the first groupie announcement.
Alan is on the air right now.
Yeah, I know he's on the air.
He can't be bothered. No one goes into the
air. Is Alan still on the air?
Yeah, Alan's still on the air. See, Alan is still on the air.
I know that, but I'm just going to poke my head in and just wait.
You poke your head in and it's going to get chopped off. Now, no one sees Alan Freed while he's on the air.
Walks in the classroom, cool and slow. Who calls the English teacher daddy-o? Charlie Brown.
Alan,
Charlie Brown.
When you're alone in there, why do you have to play it so loud?
Sydney, they always know when you're listening. Just
you wait and see. Why is everybody always picking on me?
The Coasters, Charlie Brown. They're produced right here in town by Lieber and Stoller, who just keep coming up with hit after hit after hit. This is WROL Radio 900. Hey, gang, I'm gonna have to leave you now. I'm looking forward to seeing all of you down at the Brooklyn Paramount Theater this weekend for our first anniversary rock and roll show. I hope you can all make it. And until then, just remember, it's not goodbye, just good night. I don't forget anybody.
Don't worry.
That's great. Really. I gotta go right now, but come back, will you? Anytime.
Oh, damn, he's gone.
You shouldn't be discouraged. You really liked you. He told you to come back. That's great. You sounded really good. Yeah. God, that's more than happened to me. I was in the elevator singing a song I wrote. He didn't like it at all. He didn't tell me to come back.
You know Alan Freed?
No, I don't know him. I just thought I'd audition for him. You guys gonna come back tomorrow?
Yeah, sure. We're gonna come back and maybe do one of the Falcon songs, you know?
Which one?
You're so fine. No, it's the Falcons. You're so fine. You're mine.
I love that. What else?
Maybe do something about the Cadillacs.
That's real good. Boy, you think you'd want to do an original song?
Sure.
Yeah, original song.
Well, I wrote this song about the alphabet. It's got two parts. You want to hear it?
Yeah, let's hear it.
Okay, I'll teach it to you. Okay, you guys go A, B, C, like that.
Yeah,
and you go A, I always want you.
B,
because my heart is true.
C,
come closer. I'll tell you of the ABC.
You guys should go down.
Yeah, do that. I like that.
Okay.
So it's A, I always want you.
B,
because my heart is true.
C,
come closer. I'll tell you of the ABC.
One more time.
Let's do it again. A, I always want you.
B,
because my heart is true.
C,
come closer. I'll tell you of the ABC.
One more time.
A, I always want you.
B,
because my heart is true.
C,
come closer. I'll tell you of the ABC.
I'm looking forward to seeing all of you down at the Brooklyn Paramount Theater this weekend for our first anniversary rock and roll show. I hope you can all make it.
What we're dealing with is a multi-million dollar industry, the record business, based on a very unpredictable product, the hit record. Now, there's no way to guarantee a hit, but if someone were able to determine what records were to be played, on the one hand, and influence the likes and dislikes of the potential buyers on the other, that person would be in a very powerful position in the industry. This man holds that position. He's a disc jockey named Alan Freed. These are excerpts from last night's show.
You and that hand jive's got to go. Willie said, Papa, don't
Willie and the hand jive.
Masturbation.
60-minute man.
Telling you now, they call me Loving Dan.
It doesn't matter what you turn on, it's all the same smut. Here are some more lyrics. I boogied on the stairs, I boogied in the hall, I boogied on my finger and wiped it on the wall. I'm sorry, Harriet. Freed intends to hold his first anniversary rock and roll show in New York this week. And our job is to stop him.
What time, Alan? What time?
Tomorrow night. 9:30. Tomorrow night, the recording studio. Frankie Ford, the kid from New Orleans.
Get home okay last night?
Yes.
Yeah. Where are you, little star?
What are you doing here?
I'm just passing through, man. I'm going to Florida. Boat him out. He's going south.
You're off the air?
Yeah. They tried it, and they got me. But they ain't going to keep me off, man, because I sent my tape down to Florida. I think they're going to go for a little rock and roll down there.
Well, I hope they do. Don't give me that. Look here, what I got. Hey, Mike.
Yo. Hey, Mickey.
Hey. Look at this.
All that spoof music. Don't you know kids listen to that?
Do you ever listen to it? Did you ever listen to it? Did you ever listen to it? That's a very small question. You know what bugs you, Cobb?
Shortstop, go
play with the kids. You know what makes you mad? You don't like black kids and white kids boogieing again, that's all.
Well, all right.
Because you're a bigot.
Alan, don't forget 9:30 tomorrow night.
I know.
I know. Alan. You all right?
What?
Hey, Lordy.
Are you all right?
Hey, my lady, man.
I'm worried about the show Saturday.
Worried about the show?
Yeah.
Well, you should be. So am I.
I figured we'd get the carburetor on this thing and get a little more power out of it, get around a little bit quicker.
Do anything you want. I don't care.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Thanks. Hey, you know, it's just that my cousin's driving up from Baltimore, and I don't know what to tell her about the show.
Why, any tickets or what?
No, it's not that. I mean, is there going to be a show?
Yeah, there's going to be a show. Or there won't.
It's just I've been reading in the paper, you know, about the Boston riot. And hey, is there any chance they could really just take all this away?
Yeah.
I mean, what would happen to you?
I'd be about even. No, I wouldn't. I'd be way ahead. I saw you have a couple of drinks in there tonight, you
know? See, I didn't mean it.
Well, you better be careful with this thing.
Where
exciting agenda for today. What are we going to do?
We're going to Hammocks to pick up Alan's breakfast, and then we're going to go pick up Alan.
Yeah, I know. After that?
Well, we won't be needing the car till this afternoon, so it's really none of your concern, actually.
Oh, no, I'm not a human being anymore. I'm a car. Look, what do you got on Alan's agenda for, like, late tonight?
Nothing. I'm going to be home for one thing.
Oh, yeah? Well, when you're at home, putting cold cream all over yourself.
You know, for your information, you don't put cold cream all over yourself. You just put it on your face. Which just goes to show how little you know about what girls do alone at night.
Hey, I might not know what girls do at home when they're alone, but I know what girls do when they're at home alone with me. You know what I'm saying? Wait, you're in a bad mood? Hey, I'll put you in a good mood. I got a joke for you. Want to hear a funny joke? This is good. This is great. You love this.
Does it have the F word in it? Because if it has the F word in it, I don't want to hear it. I don't listen to jokes with the F word.
It doesn't have an F word. It isn't a word joke. It's a C joke. You got to watch it, all right? Now just watch.
Well, I don't want to see it if it's got the F in it.
All right, just watch the joke. Okay, look, what do you call this? Come on, wait, what do you call it? You don't want to ask me, okay? Look, I'll tell you. In my neighborhood, we call that a beginner, you know? Yeah.
For your information, that happens to be a symbol for the sign language of the deaf. And I think that it's very wrong of you to make fun of someone else's language.
All right, the guy's a deaf beginner, all right? What, deaf people don't do this? Is that what you're telling me?
That's stupid.
A little flame in my heart.
Can I kiss your stuff?
Oh, yeah, here you go.
Thank you. Hey, Em.
What's that?
The beginner's joke.
See,
I know
what's going on.
See
you later.
You're in good company there, let me tell you.
Alan?
Hey, how you doing?
Hi. Hey, what about the concert?
What about it?
But is it still on?
Are you going to be there?
Oh, yeah, I'll be there.
Well, we're all going to be there.
Great.
Good morning.
Good morning, Alan.
Hey, morning, boss.
Morning.
Now, listen, the first thing you have on your agenda is...
Wait a minute. Mike, turn that down, will you?
See, I told you Alan would make you turn that down. Did you see this article about the Boston riot?
Just give me the billboard.
Come on, Hack, move it!
You know, people would like you a lot better if you didn't talk.
Oh, excuse me, what am I supposed to be, just another pretty face?
No, that's not exactly what I meant.
Oh, Bozo!
This is great. Sonny Mercola got fired from Atlantic. He only built the whole promotion department.
What'd you say, boss?
Sonny Mercola got fired.
What?
Just some guys, you know.
I don't understand.
He said it was just some guy. You don't require an answer.
Hey, I'm getting a little tired of you.
All right, wait.
All of my love, all of my kissing. You don't know what you've been missing, oh boy.
When I be up and call me Cheeto, but my real name is Jessica.
Listen, you putz, don't ever interrupt Mr. Freed while he's listening to an ad. Alan, I want you to realize that at 3 o'clock today, you're going to go looking at the house.
Yeah.
Michael, go back to the call with Diane for breakfast.
I don't want
to. He has to have a breakfast before he starts his day.
He wanted a breakfast. He would have brought it himself. Mr. Freed.
Will you just...
Mr. Freed, I got a breakfast before he gets these.
My name is Lenny Richfield, Richfield Records. Why don't you give me a call or... I'll tell you what, save a little lunch for Tuesday. I love you. Great. Okay.
Nice harmony.
Those guys?
Yeah. They like the Platters.
Nah, they're nothing.
Nah.
What are you doing out of school?
Me? Oh, I'm just taking the day off. Besides, it's Buddy Holly's birthday.
Birthday?
And I'm the president of his fan club.
Fan club. What do you got, about 25, 30 members?
5,000.
5,000? Say, listen, I handle a guy named Billy Moretti, you see? Kind of slick. He's Moretti. He's got that nice name, you know what I mean? Look, hey, wait a minute. No, come here. No, you do yourself a favor by starting a fan club for my boy, Billy Moretti. What's wrong?
I've never heard of Bobby Moretti.
Billy Moretti?
Yeah.
No, a lot of people haven't heard of him yet, but yeah, he'll be great. Listen, now look, this thing about Buddy Holly, you know, I knew Buddy. Matter of fact, I used to play pool with him. In fact, he still owes me money, but... Look, You gotta remember, you know, let's face it, he's dead, right? He's gone.
I know that, man, but his music isn't. Buddy Holly lives.
Yeah, well, anyway, look, my name is Lenny Ritual, Ritual Records, so why don't you just give me a call or something?
Buddy Holly lives.
Oh, Lord.
Alan, I'm waiting.
Whoa.
I'm trying to get this girl on.
Oh, Lord.
Can you hang around? I'll listen.
I know you belong to somebody new, but tonight you belong.
Okay, that's fine. Alan, listen, I want to talk to you about this. I want the kids to run your big
for you here, Alan. Any one of these is a potential. Give me the best one.
All right, you're 1,000 miles away by the heartbeats. George produces.
All right.
And you put that on your show tomorrow afternoon. It'll be solid gold in your wall by tomorrow.
Okay,
I guarantee
okay.
You have one of these, Alan.
No, come on.
All right, I appreciate it. Listen, Jesus. You don't know how much I appreciate it. I'm going to send you something.
Okay,
to
thank
show
you. Great.
Hey, look, you want to talk to this little girl out here? Is she new or something? She don't know who I am?
Oh, come on. You got it.
How many years I've been coming here?
Get out of here, Vinny.
Alan. The Debbie and Susie record. Let's put that on the show. Let's get the girls on the show. Alan, the record's going to be a million seller, Alan. What's wrong with the record?
Come on, I'm not going to play. What are you, their manager?
Alan.
I'm playing rock and roll. This is what I play. I don't play nursery rhymes.
You want to play this? No vanilla music now.
Well, listen,
right?
You got a problem with your opening act on a show, and Jerry Lee Lewis is manager.
Well,
he wants to close the show.
Get him on the phone. Alan,
there's this guy outside, Mr. Morris. He says he's a friend of yours, okay?
Good.
He's got this girl,
Morris.
Lulu. He's going to put her in the movies in California. Doing the
get her,
film
okay, Artie. Get her in here. I don't care.
Let's see.
All right, listen, you got Clark Otis from Detroit, and Willie G is from New Orleans. We're going to have to fly him up.
What do you mean, we're
going to have to fly him up? It's the only way he's going to be on the show.
Please come on in.
Why? Since
Alan, Lulu.
Hello.
Mr. Morris.
How are you?
Hi, Alan.
Right.
Hi, your friend.
Nice to see you again.
Yeah. Please, please do the salt.
Okay.
Let me hold this for you. Do it. Go ahead. All right.
Where the boys are, someone waits for me.
Thank you. Hey, that's... I don't mean to interrupt you. I'm sorry. You have a lovely voice. Well, what's the movie about?
Oh,
it's all about the movie.
The picture takes place on the beach. Boys, girls together, surf, sand, sun, music, singing.
Good luck.
It's a beauty. It's a beauty. Let me tell you.
Thank you,
Jerry. Get Jerry Lee's manager on the phone now. Listen, you're thinking too much about your music. You're not taking care of your business. These things have to be taken care of. Not an important
thing. I'm trying to get them now.
I'm trying to get them now.
Wonderful. Thank you, Mr. Morris. Alan,
get anybody's manager on the phone.
Okay, to be real serious about some business now, all right? There's a guy out there, Tyrone Blackwood, has found a girl named Laverne, got some absolutely great songs. I want us to take him in the studio and make a record.
Come on,
George
right,
will
get
jump
her in
off.
Here. Let's
here
do it.
Here we go.
Oh,
you want all these
all right.
For the show? You want
Tyrone
to all
Blackwood.
The
and the other
Laverne.
One.
Yeah,
come on.
Thousands miles away.
Miles
oh,
away.
Right, I got it. You look beautiful, though.
That's good.
Thank you. Good to see you.
Thousands
all right.
Miles away.
Okay, now, Alan. Laverne.
Hello.
Hi, Laverne.
Manager, Tyrone Blackwood.
How you doing? Okay.
All right.
Oh, yeah.
Do that great
one
song.
Sing. Sing
all right, please.
Tweedle-a, tweedle-a, tweedle-a-dee. I'm as happy as can be. Jiminy Crickets, Jiminy Jack.
Woo!
You make my heart go clickety-clack.
Okay,
you got
all right. Now, that's fantastic.
Talk
all
to
right.
Artie. Talk to Artie. You're
okay.
Going to
now, listen. We're going to get the papers together next.
All right, I'm trying
okay.
To reach
out.
I'm on the right way in a minute. You got to take care of this. This is very important now. It's got to be taken care of. You're forgetting about
the
contract. I can see you're going to scrutinize the contract.
You got to take care of this thing.
Laverne, that was just great. You got a fine manager, Laverne.
Yes, he can close the show. It's fine. I thought we... Listen, just get him there, okay? Terrific. Thanks a lot, pal. Okay.
They called Chuck Berry's manager. He was going to close
Alan,
the show
Chuck
now.
Alan,
care.
You're
going to
love
yeah,
this.
Signees.
Cleveland took two from the Yankees. See you in the studio.
So fine. You're mine. You're mine. You're mine. Baby, you're mine. Baby, you're mine. And I walk. I walk. And I talk about you. I love you.
on, get in the car. Watch him sing it. Let's go.
Get in the back here. There's seats in there you can pull down, see?
Yeah, well, you slow down. You're giving me car sick every time I get nauseous in the car from you.
Everything makes you nauseous.
No, just you.
Oh, yeah? Well, I know one thing I do that won't make you nauseous.
Oh, will you shut up?
Hey, stop hitting me.
Wait. That looks like my old high school.
Yeah, when'd you go to high school?
I thought you said you graduated from high school.
I graduated at home. I took that ICS course. You guys sing real good.
Thanks. Hey guys, before I forget, if my dad says it's okay, can you come to my house after school?
Alan, I spoke to the real estate agent, and he said that we should wait for him on the front lawn.
And maybe we can call it Freed Acres, huh, boss?
It's really gorgeous.
What do you think, guys? You think we could have a few parties in here?
Sure.
So we can't get inside until what's his name gets here,
no,
huh?
No, he won't be here for a little while.
He brought the whole neighborhood with him.
Yeah, sure is a funny way to buy a house.
Would you believe my kids both want to see this goddamn show?
Yeah, why not? 25,000 kids in Boston went to see him. I don't know what I'm doing on this case, you know?
Don't make any difference who's on it. You, me, whoever. They're gonna get him.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Alan Freed.
Oh, so good to meet you, Mr. Freed. I'm Mr. Leonard.
Mr. Leonard, you got a deal.
I beg your pardon?
I want it. I haven't been inside, but I want it.
The house.
Yeah, the house. I want to buy it.
Yes, I'm sorry to have to tell you this, but Mr. Hoagland has, he's raised the price another $15,000.
Well, what's new about that? He's done that three times in the last month. I mean, I don't care how much it costs. I just want the house. What do we have to do?
Mr. Hoagland does not want to sell to you or any music people at any price.
Well, what the hell? It's 5 o'clock. You could probably use a drink, couldn't you?
Oh, no.
A little scotch or something? What are you? Hey, Mike?
Yeah, boss.
Rocks, okay? Get us a couple of scotch and rocks, will you? Let me ask you something. You remember, like the ink spots?
Oh, well, I think so, yes.
Or Nat King Cole? You ever listen to him?
Yes, I must have.
Well, see, these guys can sing, you know, just like Nat King Cole.
Oh, really?
Or the ink spots.
Oh, I see.
Hey, Arnold?
Yeah?
Do a Sam Cooke tune.
Oh, okay.
Darling, you send me, I know you, you send me. Darling, you send me. Honest you do, honest you do, honest you do. Oh, you thrill me.
For a second. Arnold, you don't mind.
Hey, how are you?
Hey, Ron.
Hey, it's good to see you.
Good to see you.
Listen, I got a record here. It's a hit. It's a smash hit. I mean, you got
an acetate.
What's an acetate now? It'll be a record in the morning. I mean, I'll bring it over to the office for you. Listen to this title. Oh, what a night. Terrific. It's fantastic.
Bring it by.
The best thing you've ever heard. I'm putting all my money into it. Right. I'm having 500 of these pressed up.
Hey, Alan.
Buddy, how are you?
Okay, man.
You're supposed to be in Oklahoma, are you?
Oh, yeah, I'm doing a DJ bit in Tulsa, you know, but I broke this Elvis Presley record, so RCA brought me up here for a little funny game time.
They're taking good care of you?
You betcha.
You having a good time?
You bet, man. We're having a great time.
All right, Alan.
Hey.
You know Artie, don't you?
Sure, Artie.
Artie, good to see you. What you doing at sound, huh? Look at that new look. My God, what you doing here?
Oh, just coming up on a little record promotion, you know.
Fantastic. You brought your wife, I see.
Oh, you bet my cousin.
Oh, Lily Bell, a pleasure.
What are you going to do? We'll see you later.
Hey, Red.
Where's the girl?
The girl is home. George is still in the studio working with the Planetones. He's got a big problem. All of a sudden, the guys have become stars all of a sudden. Now, they're telling him what should go on.
Where's Frankie Ford?
Frankie Ford's in Studio B. Let's go in there. Watch out for this
union. You know, Red, everybody on this show has to have cars.
Alan.
Listen, Green. Everybody on this show has to have cars. This Red doesn't have a schoolhouse.
I
told you, Mario, his voice sounds great. Let me give him a little more echo. Hey, listen, doesn't he sound good?
It sounds wonderful.
Listen to this record.
Very good, see.
What do you think, honey?
I like him, but I don't like his clothes.
My part to close myself. How can you say that? Nice to see you.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Listen to this. Another Frank Sinatra.
I got to get to moving, baby. I ain't lying. My heart is beating rhythm, and it's right on time.
Put him inside. Put him over. Hey, Alan.
George.
Hey. How you doing?
Falling asleep tonight with these Planetones.
Hey, Alan, we'll go.
What's the matter with
them? We ruined them.
All right. We ruined them. We give them a hit, and now they got
Let's
no
fix
soul.
Them. What's the matter?
You need some...
Come on,
Ice in there. Yeah,
come on
inside
some...
with me. Maybe we can liven things up or something. I got to get some hand clappers or something, you know?
Get the guys.
Gene. Hey, come here.
Okay.
Oh, you got big hands, don't you?
Yeah.
Get in there.
I'm going to go
clap.
Get the chest.
Joe, over there.
What are you doing here?
I just found your biggest fan.
Oh, yeah? How you doing?
Oh, yeah.
Come on in here.
No, you're going to go in there. Come on. Let's go. All right.
Hey, this is Subway Sound. Brooklyn.
Hey.
Hey, look at this. Hey, look at Alan.
Everybody says you sound horrible. You're driving this guy nuts. He's coming in there. He's going to work with you now.
Tell him you're going to sing now.
Let's get this new song together, okay?
Girls, please take it easy. Sit down. Relax.
Everyone
in the back.
Hold it. Fellas. You're putting me to sleep again. We got to do something. Now, the song has a good melody here. We can do something with this, okay?
Hey, Fat Frank.
We got to... Hey, Frank.
George's genius is going to bail this one out.
Secondly, we need a hook to get the thing going. Some kind of dom dooby dooby. Some maybe like a dom, 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 dom. Five doms and a dom dooby. And then the tones come in with four doms against it. I'll show you. And come together on the dom dooby. Okay?
That's what made it a million dollars.
Right? I mean, you know, that's what hits are made of. We're taking about one, two, three, four.
Dom, 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 dom.
the matter? You got a headache?
No, not that. Just, I'm really worried about Alan and the show, and I don't know what we're going to do.
Hey, look. It's like, I mean, if they took it all away tomorrow, we'd be even. Right? No, we wouldn't. We'd be ahead.
Many a tear has to fall, but it's all in the game. All in the wonderful game that we know as love. You have words in a while he won't call, but it's all in the game. Soon he'll be there at your side.
Will you guys be quiet? Come on, my dad's gonna come home anytime. We'll have to quit. Okay, do
doo-wop-sa-doo, bum ba bum bum bum.
Doo-wop-sa-doo, bum ba bum bum bum.
I've always wanted to, because my heart is true. Come closer, I'll tell you of the ABCs. Darling, believe me, every day my love grows strong. But if there's doubt in my heart, I'll tell you of the ABCs.
Okay. You hear that, Arnold?
Yeah.
That's you.
Okay.
And let's do the steps. You got the steps?
Yeah. What steps?
The steps. Come on, you know.
The steps made up yesterday. Jackie,
we gotta do this and sing.
Show me that.
Yeah.
Hey, man,
I can't
do that.
Hey, let me do it.
Come on. Come on.
I can't do that.
Alan, I took down the memorandum for today, and tomorrow when I come in, I'll type it up and file it. Is that all right?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay, so that takes care of that.
Hey, boss, why don't you take her home and pick you up later?
Just meet me at Cole's, Mike, will you?
Yeah, okay, but I may be a while.
Don't worry, he'll be back in 5 minutes. What are you doing?
Yeah, you
what are you
right
doing?
There.
Where?
Well, it was
where?
A minute ago.
There is no lint on me. I'm going to ever pick lint off of me from here to
the
hand.
Right there.
I'll
get,
do all the lint.
Get out of here. I got to get on the air.
You're such an instigator.
Now you got
Alan next.
Alan,
stop.
Don't hit me with that.
You're the
one
that started
it. No, I'm not the one
that started it.
Shut the door, will you?
See, now you're forgetting about the door. I didn't leave it.
Hey, you would have let one out.
Bye-bye, my love. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, love. In case you didn't know, those guys were put in the music business by their daddy. His name is Ike Everly, and he had them singing before they could talk.
Did you hear?
Oh, man, I saw Jackie Wilson on Ed Sullivan. He was cool,
Ed Sullivan, man.
He was good,
he does
boy.
Little play stuff on Ed Sullivan. You should see him at the Apollo.
Oh, that's right. He's much better live.
The way you rub my back when I'm in pain. Huh. The way you soothe me so I won't complain. And when you kiss me with your ruby red lips, thrills me so I turn her back on.
Yeah.
I know that.
Then why are you doing my rap?
Now, if you don't quit bothering me, I'm going to have to call the law.
I just need to get a message to him. That's all.
I ain't no mailman.
Come on, this is all you got to do. Just get on the phone and call him up and tell him that the president of Buddy Holly's fan club, that's me, is downstairs and just wants to send a message at his Buddy Holly's birthday. That's all. One simple phone call.
Then what's going to happen?
You give me another mop and I'll help you clean up.
You're going to help me clean up. Come on. Oh.
Thanks,
some
Mike.
Old kid outside.
Yeah. You called or something. Send him in, sorry. How you doing?
Hi.
What's your name?
Artie Moraes.
Hi, Artie. And you're the what?
The president of the Buddy Holly fan club.
Oh, that's great. How many members you got?
5,000.
5,000, huh? That's great. Gary, bring me a couple of Buddy Holly records in here, will you? Sid, sit down there. I'm gonna pay this off, and then you do the Yankee spot and the Pall Mall back to back, okay? Sammy Turner, Lavender Blue. I love that record. It's 9:04 on WROL. This is the Big Beat. And after a couple of quick messages, I'm gonna be back with something very special. Well, have you thought about what you're gonna do when you get out of school? Thanks, Gary.
I don't know, man. My folks want me to go to school and become a lawyer, but I don't want to do that. I want to do something in music.
Something like I'm doing, you mean?
Yeah, something like that.
Well, you want to go on the radio tonight?
What can I do? I can't sing or nothing.
No, I didn't mean for you to sing. I mean, just talk about Buddy. I'll ask you some questions. Okay?
Sure.
Sid, open the 44 here and get a level on him, would you? Say something in there. Just say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 for Sid. That's Sid.
I said, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Okay, here we go. Hey, gang. I don't know if any of you remember this. I know I didn't. This is the anniversary of Buddy Holly's birthday. And the guy that told me is sitting in the booth with me. His name is Artie Moraes, and he's the president of the Buddy Holly fan club. Artie, let me ask you a few things about Buddy. What was he like off stage?
Buddy was, he was real quiet, I suppose. Especially around people he didn't know.
Well, why was that?
Up until he was 16, he had braces, and he was shy.
You think he always wanted to be a singer?
Yeah, since he was about 5 years old, he won a contest. Ever since then, he's been writing his own music.
Big ones like Peggy Sue.
Yeah, that was a big one.
What do you remember most about him?
Well, Alan, we live in Brooklyn. I live with my folks, and my dad used to come home from work and give me that look like, well, what'd you do today? Actually, you know, he's right. I didn't do nothing. I just went to school and came home and listened to music. Then one day, he came home from work with a newspaper in his hand. You know, I read the headlines and it said, Buddy Holly. Dead. Just pull me away, Alan.
Happy birthday, buddy.
Well, the little things you say and do make me want to be with you. Rain on, it's a crazy feeling, and I know it's got me leaving when you say I love you. Rain on.
Hey, buddy boy, how you doing? Just turn this key for me, and I'll be upstairs like, huh? Can you hear me? Hey, you know who I am? Hey, open this thing. What? You see these records? Hey, you see the records? These are for Alan Freed. I got an appointment with Alan Freed.
Oh,
I know what you mean. I know what you mean. Little five spot, huh? Little five spot ought to turn this key. How you like this, Gramps? This'll buy you a few cigars. Huh? All right. A Tenski ought to turn this lock. A little Tenski. A little Tenski. Here we go. This is for you. That's real, Pops. Now open this thing. Hey, come here, Gramps. Hey, you forgot to open this. Hey, open the door! Hey!
You got long distance on line two.
Yeah, hi, Dad. Yeah, I caught. How are you? You got a lot of rain down there, huh? Yeah, well, I called because, you know, I got the check back. I mean, why can't I give you anything? Yeah, okay, I'm sorry. I forgot, you know, how late it is for you. Yeah, I'm on the air right now. I'll talk to you next week or something, okay? Okay, bye.
What's your record, Alan?
This is Alan Freed, and I love you. You know what? It's raining in Akron, Ohio, but it's a beautiful night in New York City. These are the Drifters, and there goes my baby.
Take your feet down from there. You know what your mother says.
I'm sorry.
You are not sorry.
I am sorry.
We have to talk, you and me. Mother, would you mind leaving us alone for a few minutes so I can talk to your daughter?
Go ahead. She won't talk to me.
You see that? You are killing your mother. She loves you. She worries about you.
I feel fine. Huh. I love her, too.
Well, you certainly don't show it. Now, you know she's got her heart set on you going to college.
That's not what I'm going to do.
Louise, we all have to do things we don't want to do in order to grow up to be decent people.
I'm a grown-up. I'm a decent person.
Look, that's not what I mean. Look, I don't speak for myself. I speak for your mother. You're driving her crazy. You bring those colored boys up to the house here.
Those guys are my friends.
Well, I can maybe understand that. This is the modern age. But maybe your mother can't understand it. She's a very nervous woman. You're going to give her a breakdown. Now, you want to be a composer? Look around you. All your best composers went to college. Irving Berlin went to college.
Irving Berlin. I'm going to do it the way I want to do it. I mean, you haven't even heard any of the songs I've written, have you? Not one of them. Come here. I want you to listen to something I wrote, okay? Schemes, and I don't have hopes and dreams, and I don't have anything since I don't have you.
This is Alan Freed. It looks like we made it. Tomorrow is our first anniversary rock and roll show, and I know everybody's going to be there. But for those of you who can't, this show is going to be pre-recorded. You kids have made it a great year for me, and I want to thank you, especially my friends in the music business. So, remember, it's not goodbye. It's just good night. I love you, New York.
Mm-hmm.
sleep, will you?
Office brought this by today. Now, you got a sign or you could be in a lot of trouble. All it is an affidavit stating that you never received money or gifts to play any records.
I can't sign that.
Four of the top disc jockeys in the country have already signed it.
Well, they're lying.
Alan, if you don't sign this, I can't protect you. The station can't protect you.
Look, you can't protect me anyway. I mean, don't you get it, Pete? I mean, the only way you can protect me is if I stop playing rock and roll. If I stop playing Little Richard.
Alan, this is serious.
Pete, what are they going to do? They're going to shut us down here or what?
No, not us. You.
Oh, man, we ain't never going to get along with Pete's show.
Don't worry about it.
I hear she's some tough action,
man. Yeah, but I still want to be an Alan Freed show. All that practicing we did and stuff.
Let's do some singing.
You never know. You never know.
And Julie, darling, the angels will sing. I tell you, darling, queen of my throne, you should have known, sweetheart.
Sweetheart.
Known, sweetheart.
Well, 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 ling, 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 ding, dong. I love you, darling, and I want you for my own.
How y'all doing? School's almost over, huh? What are y'all gonna do all summer?
I'm going surfing.
You're going what? You're going surfing? Where'd you hear about that?
Yeah.
What are you gonna do?
Oh, I gotta work.
Where are you gonna work?
Macy's?
That's a good job. You're gonna make some money, huh?
Just work in the basement, but I got a radio so I can listen to you.
Attagirl.
That's good. Boss, I'm getting hungry.
Well, get... Hey, we're gonna get you all some coffee and some donuts out here. It's freezing. How you fellas doing tonight? It's a little chilly out here, isn't it?
It's okay. Hey, Fred, what time you plan on opening this box office?
About noon tomorrow.
I'm telling you something. You're gonna have a security problem. You don't keep those kids in line out there.
Oh, don't you worry now. They're gonna be having a good time.
Yeah, well, that's up to you, Fred. You know what I mean?
I know that.
You do your job and I'll do my job, okay?
All right, don't worry about it.
I ain't worried.
Hey, teenager, how are you?
I'm fine, how are you? Listen, what do you think of the Chesterfields?
I think they might be great.
What do you think about giving an unknown act a break?
What do you mean, on this?
Yeah.
Oh, honey, I can't do that. They don't even have a record. I mean, nobody knows who they are. There's thousands of kids here. Listen, here's four tickets. You just come to show. Everything will work out.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
Chapter 3, remember the meaning of romance. In chapter 4, you break up, but you give it just one more chance.
Oh, I wonder, but do.
Ooh. Who wrote the book of love? Two off the 101, two off the 101, two off the 101.
Well, I've got to know the answer.
Yeah.
That's it. That's it.
The film you see is live at the Brooklyn Paramount Theater, where storms of teenagers have been lining up since 4 a.m. this morning. A police spokesman has said that these rock and roll enthusiasts have been behaving relatively calmly. But one wonders what jungle instincts will be aroused when the doors are closed, the lights go down, and the caterwauling begins.
They're really rocking in Boston and Pittsburgh, PA. Deep in the heart of Texas and round the Frisco Bay. All over St. Louis and down in New Orleans. All the cats gonna dance with sweet little 16. Sweet little 16. She just got to have about a half a million. Famed autographs. Her wallet filled with pictures. She gets them one by one. Becomes so excited. Watch her look at her run.
Get out of hand. Remind them, use good judgment. I don't want to give this crowd any excuse to become an angry mob.
So I don't believe this.
Could become that very easily from the looks of things. Look at that filth. It's like a garbage dump.
That with a Gillette. Try it, will you?
Sharp.
Take care of the one I love. Ooh.
position.
I'm trying to get him in a coffin.
In the coffin? I don't know. If you get him in the coffin, he don't belong to me. We'll call the cemetery workers. But if he's out, I want to see a card.
All right, let's go. I got 4,000 people waiting out there. Let's go. Let's get in there.
Okay.
Look at this thing. I mean, how much air you think is in there? There's all kinds of air. Look at the room you got in there. I mean, how much air is in there when you close the lid? That's what I want to know.
I want to come.
Thank you. back here that thought she could write a song. She came to me, and she found these guys standing around singing on a street corner, and they don't have a big hit record right now, but I want you to let me know if they're going to have one tomorrow. The Chesterfield!
Thank you.
What's wrong with you?
Nothing's wrong, Alan. Everything's great. It's so great. They really love my songs. They love the lyrics, they love the melodies, everything. I can't believe it. Oh, God. Alan, I never had anything till I found the music.
Neither did I.
Montreal, when you was too high to bring me out, the third act was on before you even knew the show would begin. You was feeling no pain, baby.
You didn't show up a couple of times.
Oh, no, oh, no.
Alan.
Oh, no. That's a
Alan, what?
Box office, just call. The IRS attached all the receipts.
They what?
You're not going to be able to pay anybody.
Oh, wow. Hey, Fried, it's your responsibility to let this audience know your two-star performers aren't going on.
Something else is going on here, huh?
You know, rock and roll's been pretty good to me. I think I'll do this one for rock and roll. Oh, man. Bring me on. Bring me on.
Hey! What can I say? Mr. Chuck!
She claims she don't, but I know she do, and we wish. Quarter to 4. She didn't even wait 3 minutes. She said, give me some more. Ooh, Chuck, baby, that show feel fine. Looked at my watch and it was 9:45. You know she turned around and made me do it again.
Mr. Rock and Roll, from Faraday, Louisiana, Jerry Lee Lewis.
Here we go. You get my nerves and you rattling my brain. Too much you get to drive a man insane. It broke my will, but what a thrill. Goodness and rage, quick balls of fire. I have the nerve, but I thought it was funny. Balls of fire. Get me, baby. Feels so good. Why don't you hold old Jerry Lee, mama? Yeah. Let me love you like a lover should. nervous, but it sure is fun. Come on, baby.
Well, what's your problem?
You've got people jumping around in the aisles like a bunch of lunatics. Now, if it keeps up, it's a fire hazard. We'll have to turn the lights on.
Well, you just can't stand to watch a bunch of kids have a good time, can you?
Oh, it's you I can't stand, Green.
Oh.
I can't stand what you're doing to these kids. You're making them behave like a bunch of animals.
Let me love you like a lover should. You're fine. It's hard to do a rock and roll show when they turn all the lights on. You can't do it. Now, if the people that take you in the auditorium or the theater, whatever it may be, the police is pretending to their job, Alan Freed's doing his job. Let Jerry Lee Lewis do his job and turn the damn lights on.
Close the show. You can stop me. But you're never gonna stop rock and roll, don't you know that?
You're fine. Go kind. I wanna tell this world that you're mine, mine, mine. Come on, baby. Drive the crazy. Riddle is courageous. Sweet balls of fire.
The only thing that's gonna cause a riot is you turning the lights on. Why don't you just go home?
Cheap to replicate all in the aisle, blocking it.
All right, close it down.
All right, show's over.
Everybody rock, stay, it will never die. It was meant to be that way, though I don't know why. I don't care what people say, rock and roll is here to stay.
Rock out!
But if you like to bop and stroll, come around and listen. Let's all start to have a ball. Everybody